Here are this week's new and trending AI tools that will help you level up your content creation. Coming up, an AI transcription tool that's better than anything we've seen before, and a new open source AI that could be better than ChatGPT-4 and Claude Opus 3 to work on your content creation. But first, the new Adobe Express app is here. And why is that important? Well, Adobe Express has been pretty explosive in the realm of AI and content creation for a while, working on desktop. But this week, they announced that they're bringing all of their generative AI features to mobile. So whether you're on iOS or Android, you can do some pretty cool things. Let's dive in and see what's possible, starting with text to image. Now, this is absolutely fantastic. You can now type a text prompt, a stunning photo of a unicorn in a beautiful forest. Let's try creating a sunny Parisian cafe scene with colorful umbrellas and people enjoying their coffee. Now you can see within moments, Adobe Express has come back with some really good images just from a text prompt on my mobile. Incredible. But we can further refine the image generation by clicking the back button, choosing a content type like photo, and going for a specific style. So I might actually choose to go for something that looks rather neon and generate that. And it's taken my prompt and further refined it to give me these beautiful looking images that I can easily use in, say, a travel vlog that I'm working on. So once I'm happy with what I've got, I can click the download button, and this can then be downloaded to my phone like so, in many different formats from PNG to JPEG or even PDF if needed. I've also got the ability with one tap here to share to the social network of my choice, making AI content creation and social media seamless on my mobile phone. Next up, let's look at removing objects from photos I've already taken on my phone. I've got this beautiful image of my son in San Pellegrino Therme in Italy, but maybe I want to use generative fill to remove him from the image. Now I can decrease or increase the size of my brush, let's make it a little bit smaller so I can be nice and precise, and just using my finger here, I'm painting over the areas where he appears in the image, being careful to try and include every single bit of him so generative fill can do its job. And boom, now I have some incredible options of that scene on its own without a person in it to use in my social media posts. And of course, the generative AI options don't stop there, because I can actually insert an object as well. So I've used nighttime stars in the sky as a prompt. I'll increase my brush size quite a bit, and then I'm going to use that big brush to select all of the sky that I can just above the mountains there in Italy and click insert. And that's pretty cool, isn't it? Within moments, we've got some options as to how that nighttime sky could look. Now, if we're not happy and we want to do more, we just click more, and there you have it, more options to choose from here. I'm absolutely digging this generation, so let's click to keep it. Another cool feature of Adobe Express is the ability to remove the background with one click. Here, I've got a photo I really like of myself that's taken outdoors. I click remove background. And boom, now I've got a perfectly usable image that I can drag to resize, I can rotate it in any way I like, and I can even edit and add some text in here too. Talking about adding text in, let's look at the text effects option. Again, another great generative AI feature in Adobe Express. Now we can either start with a style here that's suggested in the templates, or we can describe a style. I'm just using water droplets as my prompt, and that's pretty cool. Now we can go ahead and further edit it once we've got that water generated text by going to style and maybe choosing something different. We've got pencil sketch, neon, colorful fine lighter, embellish. Let's try that. And let's make it loose so it goes outside of the text rather than being tight inside the text. And as you'll see with the refinement of my prompt, we've got a few different suggestions here that automatically generate on your text. If I like the text that I generated here, I can actually go across to more at the bottom menu, click copy, go back to this earlier image where I removed the background, more, and click paste. To make it pop, I'll click into effects, add a shadow, move it around. Again, maybe use copy and paste to copy the image I generated and altered earlier, and then tap and hold that image and send it backward. And now we have a really usable image of me in San Pellegrino with the word Mike with watery droplets, all created with the help of AI in the Adobe Express app on my mobile phone. Let's go ahead and share that to social media. And in case you're worried of losing anything you create or generate on your mobile, it's all saved inside the Your Stuff folder. So there are my multiple generations all retained for me. So the new Adobe Express, now with AI features baked in for mobile users, allowing anyone with a mobile phone to take pictures, alter and enhance them with AI, create their own text effects, add and remove things, pop out the person from an image by removing the background. There are so many cool features, and I definitely recommend you download and try it. There is a free plan that gives you, I believe, 25 generations every month, or you can upgrade. It really is a must-have app for content creators. No matter where you are, you've got AI right in your pocket now with Adobe Express. Next up, a superior transcription tool for content creators. Whether you're a podcaster looking for the most accurate transcription or a YouTuber wanting to get a really cool transcript for your YouTube videos, Universal 1 from AssemblyAI is reported to be better than OpenAI's Whisper, and it comes with less hallucinations and lots of multilingual capabilities. As you'll see here, it's been trained on 12.5 million hours of multilingual audio data. It's also got some pretty good benchmarks, making it the best versus OpenAI's Whisper Large version 3, Microsoft's models, DeepGram, Amazon, and Google, all tail behind this new AI transcription tool. So let's give it a go. I will, of course, have a link down below in the description to go ahead and try this out for yourself in AssemblyAI's playground. And if you're liking what you see so far, do like and subscribe to my channel, because I have weekly tutorials on the newest and trending AI tools for content creation. So here we are in the AssemblyAI playground. I can go ahead and start by uploading an audio file. And this time I'm going to upload a podcast I did, ironically, about transcriptions. Once that's done, I've got a number of models to choose down here on the left-hand side. I'll start with one that we need all the time as content creators, summarization. Now, this is pretty incredible because that's a 23 megabyte MP3 file and it's just over 30 minutes in duration. You can see over here to the right hand side, it has given me a nice summarization. So it says that it dives deep into creativity aided by artificial intelligence. It says here that I did demonstrate Otter AI, which I certainly did, and that it can assist you with Google Meet and Zoom. I also said that Descript is a good tool. It's got a lot of good stuff here. Sonic's AI. It also says here that Isabella loved the fact that it's incredibly easy to use with YouTube. A really great summarization of some of the topics discussed. Let's run another model on this audio. So you'll see some of the other models here include topic detection, auto chapters, content moderation, important phrases for finding highlights in your content, maybe to use for shorts or quotes on social media. I'm actually going to go ahead and try the auto chapters, which we particularly need for YouTube videos. And here we can see the different chapters that have been generated. So an introduction on AI tools for creators about transcripts, a little tutorial to start with, how to transcribe a podcast in the future, two great tools for summarization, Otter AI, and so on and so on. So you can see how this can be used to instantly get the topics discussed and put them into different chapters. Finally, I'll have one more go with this tool. I've uploaded a file and you see there's a bunch of different tools like speaker labels, particularly handy when you have a podcast with multiple speakers in. But I'm actually going to go ahead and use sentiment analysis to analyze this particular podcast. Now, I know this podcast was a hot topic and I disagree quite frequently with my co-host on the future of AI chatbots. Let's see if the tool picks this up. And here you'll see it's complete and it identified a total of 94 positive sentences and 70 negative ones. Now, sadly, I couldn't find out how to highlight the positive and negative sentences. I'm sure that AssemblyAI's new transcription tool allows you to do that, but potentially in the playground that I'm using for free right now, that option is not available to me. But you can see how this tool would be fantastic, not only for analyzing the sentiment in a podcast, but also for taking your meetings and finding out how much of the meeting was positive and how much of it was negative. The opportunities with this new transcription tool that apparently is the best right now are endless. Go and try it for yourself with the link down below. Finally, I couldn't finish this week's roundup without including a new AI chat tool from Meta. Llama 3 dropped yesterday, and I wanted to explore the possibilities for content creators to use this powerful new open source model, which in benchmarks accelerates over Google's Gemma and also many Mistral models as well. Now, you can access it on Meta's AI website, but that is geo-locked, and some regions, including the UK, cannot access it. So go and try it out on Hugging Face Chat, and I'll place the link down below to this. If it's not already selected, click the cog here and make sure you select Meta Llama 3 70B Instruct as the active model. Now let's put it through its paces. As a content creator, I constantly need catchy titles, descriptions, and even tags for my YouTube videos. So here I'm going to type in, please summarize this YouTube video, suggesting a new title, description, and tags based on the transcript content. Then triple quotes here. This is the text of my transcript, so I'm going to copy that over, and I'll paste it inside the triple quotes here and see what comes back. And here, almost instantly, it came up with the answers. Reka AI model review, multimodal capabilities and limitations. In this video, I review the model, and it gives me some very, very solid tags there. So I'm giving that a massive thumbs up for YouTube title description and tagging. I love the capabilities of Llama 3 for this. Next, I'm going to put in another prompt, and this is going to be to make timestamped chapters based on the transcript for the YouTube video. And again, here they are. It's coming out nicely, and it is recognizing the whole video, although I'm noticing that it is hallucinating because it's saying that the video is 21 minutes in duration or 21 minutes 30, whereas I know this video actually lasted 6 minutes and 20 seconds. So while the chapters look very convincing and the information looks right, it has hallucinated those timestamps. So it's a thumbs down for Llama 3 on that particular task. Finally, I'll check its memory retention and possibilities to search online and get me some answers by ticking search the web. And this one, I'm going to say, please search online and find out what people are saying about this subject. Notice I didn't say about Reka AI, so we'll see if it remembers the previous threads in my conversation. And it's really good here. Yep, it's definitely taking into account that we're talking about Reka AI here. It's giving a comparison, use cases and applications, and exactly how people are finding it. The negative sentiments here. We've also got the positive sentiments found online. So it's a really awesome summarization using information that's clearly already out there and online. So a thumbs up from Llama 3 and its web searching capabilities and summarization there. So overall, I'd say this is the most powerful open source AI language model we've had yet. And Mark Zuckerberg has even said they're still training further Llama 3 models that they haven't even released with more power.
You know, an 8 billion and a 70 billion, which we're releasing today, and a 405 billion dense model, which is still training.
So we really look forward to seeing some information on that soon. Meanwhile, if you'd like to check out the Reka Core model that I actually used in this example, go and watch that video next, because I released that video earlier in the week to show you multimodal capabilities of a new AI chat tool that apparently is better than Claude Opus 3 in recent benchmarks. Thanks for watching this. Let me know in the comments which tool you found most useful. And remember, if you want more tools just like this, subscribe to my AI newsletter. I update you weekly with everything I find. I cut through the fluff and I get just the really good stuff that you'll need to make excellent quality content. Link to that in the description down below.